The global high-tech industry has long been dominated by the United States, with groundbreaking inventions like the computer, the internet, and mobile phones being just a few examples. However, China has rapidly closed the gap in the past decade. In this video, I will explore the current state of the high-tech industry, examining the positions of both China and the USA. Additionally, I will study countries significantly affected by the rise of China's high-tech sector. Our story begins with China. When the People's Republic of China was founded in 1949, its total industrial output was a mere $10 billion. Fast forward to 2023, and this figure has surged to nearly $5 trillion, an astonishing 500-fold increase. China initially focused on producing cheap goods using low-cost labor, supported by favorable government policies. The true transformation began when China joined the World Trade Organization, WTO, in 2001. Foreign capital flowed into China as companies sought to maximize profits by taking advantage of the country's manufacturing potential. While the United States was occupied with wars and managing the aftermath of the 9/11 terrorist attacks, China quietly built its factories, developed expertise, and cultivated talents. However, everything changed in 2015 when the Chinese government unveiled its Made in China 2025 initiative. This ambitious plan sent shockwaves through the U.S. as it began to realize the far-reaching consequences that could emerge if China succeeded in its industrial and technological ambitions. Let's set geopolitics aside and focus on the Made in China 2025 initiative, which is due for completion next year. After 9 years, what has been achieved, and where does progress still fall short? To better understand, we must first define what Made in China 2025 is. Launched in 2015, Made in China 2025 aims to transform China's industrial foundation by achieving self-sufficiency in critical technologies, boosting innovation, and shifting the nation up the global value chain. The initiative places particular emphasis on advancing high-tech industries in 10 key sectors, including robotics, aerospace, ocean engineering and high-tech ships, railway equipment, power equipment, new materials, new energy vehicles, biotechnology, agriculture machinery, and artificial intelligence. Let's begin with robotics. Thanks to its vast industrial base, China is now the world's largest producer and consumer of industrial robots. In 2022, China contributed to more than 50% of global robot installations, far surpassing other nations. The United States trails in a distant third. However, when it comes to the companies dominating the market, the Swiss-Swedish group ABB leads the global industrial robotics sector, holding a 21% market share in 2022. There is no Chinese company in the top 10. China's largest industrial robotics company is Saisen Robotics, with over 4,000 employees. As you might expect, it's state-owned, operating under the Chinese Academy of Sciences, which reflects China's strategy of leveraging state-backed enterprises to drive innovation and industrial growth. As for the United States, the only company in the top 10 is Amran Adept, holding just a 3% market share. At first glance, it might seem that China's progress in this field has a minimal impact on the U.S. However, this is a simplified perspective. To fully understand the situation, we need to consider ownership and production locations of these companies. Take ABB as an example. It produces a significant portion of its products in China, with 85% of its sales in China coming from locally produced goods. The company also employs about 15,000 people in China, contributing not only to local employment but also to government tax revenue. In this way, even foreign-owned companies are fueling China's economic engine, making the dynamics of global robotics far more complex than just market share. Another key area of interest is service robots, machines designed to assist humans by performing useful tasks across commercial, domestic, and professional environments. Unlike industrial robots, which are typically confined to manufacturing settings, service robots operate in more dynamic spaces like homes, hospitals, hotels, airports, and retail stores. These robots are equipped with sensors, artificial intelligence, and, in some cases, machine learning, enabling them to autonomously or semi-autonomously navigate, interact, and complete complex tasks. Key sectors include logistics, warehousing, and healthcare, where service robots are making a significant impact. China, in particular, has experienced rapid growth in warehouse automation and last-mile delivery robots, fueled by the expansion of e-commerce giants like JD.com and Alibaba. Chinese companies such as Geek Plus have emerged as global leaders, advancing the development of logistics robots that are setting new standards in efficiency and technology worldwide. On the other hand, the U.S. leads the world in healthcare-related robots, especially in surgical robots like the Da Vinci surgical system developed by Intuitive Surgical. U.S. hospitals are early adopters of advanced robotic systems for precision surgeries and patient care. Both China and the U.S. are global leaders in service robot development but focus on different strengths. China excels in rapid commercialization and deployment of service robots, particularly in logistics, hospitality, and healthcare, supported by strong government backing. Meanwhile, the U.S. is a pioneer in robotics innovation and advanced R&D, with strengths in medical robotics, AI, and autonomous systems. The final category I want to discuss is military robotics. Both China and the United States have invested heavily in military robotics, but their approaches, technological focus, and strategic goals differ significantly. While the U.S. has long been a pioneer in developing advanced autonomous systems for military applications, China is rapidly catching up, driven by its ambitions to modernize its armed forces and gain technological parity with the U.S. China has made substantial progress in developing combat drones and surveillance unmanned aerial vehicles UAV. Companies like China Aerospace Science and Technology Corporation produce military-grade drones such as the CH-4 and Winglong 2, which are increasingly being exported to other nations. These UAV have proven effective in reconnaissance and strike missions comparable to the U.S. MQ-9 Reaper. Conversely, the U.S. has maintained its dominance in drone warfare for decades. Systems like the MQ-1 Predator and MQ-9 Reaper have played pivotal roles in U.S. counterterrorism operations globally. Additionally, the U.S. is advancing next-generation UAV such as the RQ-180, which feature enhanced stealth, increased autonomy, and the capability to execute complex missions with minimal human intervention. China is developing several advanced drones that aim to compete with the U.S. RQ-180. One notable project is the WZ-8, a high-altitude reconnaissance drone designed for strategic surveillance and intelligence gathering. Next, we turn our attention to swarm robotics. China is a pioneer in drone swarming technology, where multiple autonomous drones work together to overwhelm adversaries. In recent demonstrations, China showcased its ability to deploy large swarms of drones that could be used for offensive or surveillance missions, marking a potential shift in future warfare tactics. In conclusion, the competition between China and the United States in robotics spans various sectors, from military applications to service robots and autonomous systems. The U.S. has long been a leader in advanced robotics, particularly in military technology and drone warfare, leveraging its historical experience and technological innovation. Meanwhile, China is rapidly closing the gap through substantial investments and strategic initiatives aimed at modernizing its capabilities across the board. Ultimately, the race in robotics reflects broader geopolitical dynamics, with both nations striving for technological superiority to enhance their strategic and economic interests. As advancements continue to unfold, the global landscape of robotics will likely play a crucial role in determining the future balance of power. This concludes the first part of my series on China versus USA and high-tech advancements. Thank you for watching, and be sure to return for the next video.